Hello and welcome to our special Summer Sunday Morning Together. I really hope that you're enjoying this time off school and having lots of fun. You might even be watching this from your holidays. So we have been looking at Moses in the Bible, and so far we've heard how he was sent by God to Egypt to rescue God's people, the Israelites, from slavery. After the 10 plagues, the Pharaoh finally told the Israelites to go. As they were leaving, he changed his mind and chased after them. The Israelites were trapped by the sea until God parted the water and they could escape. So God's people were now on a journey to a land that they would call their very own, which they called the Promised Land. While they were walking through the desert, the Israelites complained about having no food, but God continued to look after them in the desert. He sent quails and manna to them every day, except the Sabbath day, which God wanted them to keep special. And when they moaned about being thirsty, God helped Moses to find water. Even though God kept looking after the Israelites, they still made bad choices. So God asked Moses to come and speak with him up a mountain, and he gave the world the Ten Commandments. God really wanted them to know how to live the best way, and this would help them. While Moses was talking with God, the Israelites broke the second commandment of making a pretend God, and this made God very angry. While Moses was talking with God, he wanted to know who was going with him, like would he have any help from one of God's angels? But God tells him something very exciting. Moses will have God traveling with him. Moses asked that God allow him to actually look upon God's glory, so perhaps that he could offer the Israelites an eyewitness account of God's presence. Moses' request was a bold one. Imagine how he must have felt when God said yes. There was one thing, however. God warned Moses that his holiness was so big that no human could actually experience it and survive. So God allowed Moses to look at him only as God started to disappear and he'd covered up his face like he was protecting Moses. There is a psalm in the Bible that tells us more about God's perfection, focusing on how holy and awesome he is. Just as God was too holy for Moses to look at, God's holy is so magnificent that the world should tremble and the earth should quake. Because even God's name is holy. And we've learned before that when something is holy, it means it's very special, that it's set aside just for God. In the Bible, someone's name means more than just how we call that person. Did you know in Hebrew culture, it often represented a whole of who the person was, the core inside them. So to know someone's name was to truly know a person inside and out. There are lots of stories in the Bible about someone getting a new name because they had changed and their new name had a new meaning. So it was so special for Moses to see how powerful, awesome, and holy God was in that way. A few chapters later, when Moses had finished speaking with God, the Bible tells us that after his special time with God, his face was shining bright and that all the rest of the Israelites could see that. I wonder what that would have been like to see. Moses had a very special time with God that very few people in the Old Testament had. But guess what? That's just what God offered to the world when he sent Jesus to live with us. In all the holiness and specialness that Jesus, he hugs us and he wants to be friends with us. Knowing Jesus is such a special gift. And when we live with Jesus in our hearts, we want to share that and have our faces shining bright too. Over and over again, God wanted to prove to the Israelites that it was him that was looking after them. God wanted to leave no doubt that the manna and the water were coming from the almighty, all-powerful God. God wants us to know without a doubt that he was taking care of his people. God wanted Israel to know it was him and to trust him. God wanted Israel's trust and he wants yours and my trust too. I'm really glad that you could join us again today for another story. If you'd like to continue learning, there are some worksheets in the Google Drive link in the description of this video below. I hope that you have a brilliant week and keep enjoying your summer holidays.